Hi and welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick, where we're going to be meeting some people who are participating and performing at the Melbourne Fringe Festival, which is coming up this month. And the first guest is Jeremy Moses.
Hello, Henry. Thank you so much for having me.
My pleasure. I just got an email from you the other day, and I'm thinking, how difficult is it to get guests these days? Because we had to do a repeat last week because Yontif is on. You know, Jewish holidays really interferes with the shtick.
For sure.
And I got an email from you, and I said, who's this Jeremy Moses? He sounds Jewish. yeah. So you're a slam poet.
I am, yeah. It's been a dream of mine to come on your show ever since I figured out how to tune Channel 31, and it's great to be here. Yeah, I am a slam poet, a bad slam poet, if you will.
Really? What's so bad about your slam poetry?
When it's done well, it's a lot of good spoken word rhyming, and there's a lot of clicking, like the audience clicks when you finish and you do well.
Wow.
When I do it, it's very silly. I wear a beret and I blow a harmonica, and yeah, it's bad, but it's good, I think.
Right, because I think comedy is really silly. It really is. The sillier it is, the more people laugh.
I would hope so, yeah. I hope I get some laughs.
Yeah, well, you've been doing this shtick. You call yourself a comedian as well as a writer. You were famously became almost famous during the lockdown when you were doing social media, and you did 100 shows in 100 days.
100 poems, yeah. It was a long haul. I started doing like a handful of them. But then I kept watching the news and they kept having all these stories. And I was like, oh, that'd be a great poem. That'd be a lot of fun.
Mm. So you turned the news into art.
Yeah, like four lines. And I did like 100 in 100 days, which is ridiculous.
Yep.
And then after that...
What else is there to do during lockdown?
Exactly, yeah. I had to fill in the time somehow. In a way, it kind of saved me. It gave me something to do. And then after that, I did the elections. And so I added them all up, and they all add up to 157 minutes of slam poetry, of bad slam poetry. And I made a fringe show about it.
Right. Yeah. So that's the title of your show.
157 minutes of bad slam poetry, yeah. But it only goes for an hour, I assure your audience.
We don't want to overdose.
No.
We can't handle 3 hours as like Barbie, you know, or Oppenheimer, you know. I haven't been going to the movies because I just can't sit still that long.
It can be exhausting.
Movies just go on forever. I just find it really hard.
Yeah, sorry.
I think even 8 or 10 minutes of segments on the shtick is difficult to get people's attention, get the eyeballs.
Bring back the intermission, I say. Yeah, let people go to the bathroom. But, an hour is probably too long for my show.
Yeah. You're originally from Sydney, and then you studied film.
Yes, that's right. I got a diploma in film and TV.
Where's that? Where were you studying?
North Sydney.
Right.
And I made a bunch of short films and mini documentaries.
Your shtick's interesting because you've also got a disability aspect where you've got a visual impairment.
That's correct. Yeah, I'm actually legally blind.
Mm.
I've got a genetic condition called optic atrophy plus.
Yep. Which is a balance
issue? Yeah, it affects my balance, it affects my eyesight.
Yep.
So I'm low vision, and also I look drunk when I walk.
Yeah. You've been picked up by the police?
No, but I've been kicked out of bars before.
Oh, really?
And
you're intoxicated. Get out.
Yeah, exactly. Right. My show, I'll talk about that. I've got a lot of stories about awkward public interactions. And
right.
Yeah, but it's fine. I think it encourages me to focus more on wordplay. And I've always been drawn to the spoken word.
Mm.
The show is a lot about disability because not a lot of people talk about it, I find. So it's good, yeah. It's a bit of advocacy.
Well, it's become much more speakable now. It wasn't unspeakable. They just had the commission, and it's an outrage.
Yeah.
It's a complete outrage. I mean, it's so bad what's been going on for years and years within the disability sector.
Yeah.
And nothing seems to have been done. It's the same as with the First Nations people. I mean, it's been going on for years, and still nothing's being done. You wonder why we have government.
Yeah. So I think if more people talk about things, like issues, then hopefully it shines a light on them. And hopefully, by being a stand-up comedian who has a disability.
You should be a sit-down comedian. You can't stand up.
It would make life a lot easier if I was. Yeah.
Yeah, you should get a stool.
But a lot of comics do really mean stuff about disability. They make fun of Down syndrome.
Yeah, I know. Well, that's old. You can't do that anymore.
No. tend to be very clean.
Yeah.
I'm very silly, lots of wordplay, and I talk about my disability and my Iraqi Jewish family.
Right, so you're Iraqi Singaporean. Where's the Singaporean
business coming from? Yeah, my mum's side is from Singapore, my dad's side is from India.
Right.
And both sides descend from Iraq, Baghdad.
Baghdad.
So we're Baghdadi Jews.
Baghdadis.
Yeah, it's unusual.
How cool is that?
But it's pretty amazing. Like, no one really knows about, you know, synagogues in Singapore, synagogues in India.
Yep. So I do. This is one of my favourite fields of study, actually. I love following the Jewish trail all over the world.
We're a fascinating bunch.
Yeah, we are.
There's some contention of whether my family is Sephardi or Mizrahi.
Yeah.
But, either way, we're Baghdadi.
You could be either, because I'm mixed as well. You know, so let's just enjoy being unique. And talking about unique, I'd like to finish off with just talking about your advocacy for more accessibility and inclusivity. It's very important to be included.
It is. Yeah, definitely. Our venue is the Classic Southside, which is above the cinema in Elsenwick. Yep. And it's an accessible venue, and the staff are very nice. And
there's a lift.
Yeah, there's a lift and ramps. Yep. The staff are very accommodating.
Yes.
The Fringe is a great festival for accessibility and inclusivity. And we've made tour videos of the venue so people can see how to get to the venue.
That's interesting.
It's important. Yeah, not many. I mean, productions need to do that, I think, and include people, get more people to come.
Mm-hmm.
The more people who can enjoy art, the better. And if what I do is considered art, then then I'm grateful for their attendance. Yeah,
it's definitely art. And the dates you're on is from October 11 to 15?
Yeah, correct. October 11 to 15.
And how do they get tickets?
Melbournefringe.com.au.
Yep.
Or 03-9660-9666.
Yep.
That's for the phone box office. And the Sunday matinee at 2 p.m., we're doing a sensory-friendly, relaxed matinee, and the house lights will be on. People can come and go, and I'll be making extra descriptions, and we'll have reduced lighting and reduced volume. Yeah, it'll be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to it.
Fantastic. Well, it's really great to meet you. I love getting fresh people on the show. Do you want to do the harmonica shtick now? We're going to end with a bit of harmonica?
I'm as fresh as they come. Yeah, of course. Yeah, please. In lockdown, I did a poem about Jewish New Year, and I'll
Would
do
it be appropriate now?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Good timing, Apples and honey, a new year has started. Tell us the tale of the dead seas that parted. We'll meet Grandma on Zoom and consume fish heads half-hearted. And when she hits mute, we'll assume Nana farted.
Get down. Thanks, Jeremy. It's been great to have you on. And we'll be coming back with a young lady by the name of Robin Reynolds, who's running. She's also doing a show at the Fringe Festival. And she's a comedian of sorts. She'll be walking through the door. She's actually driving down from Sydney as we speak. And she'll be turning up going, you know how you feel after a trip from Sydney? They stopped at Albury overnight.
Yeah, she's brilliant. Highly recommended. Robin Reynolds, very, very good. I've seen her a couple of times.
And she'll be on the shtick in the next segment. Thank you so much.